truckers, it is a beautiful day for trucking in the USA. I'm just getting out of the house right now, just leaving home, getting back on the road here. You guys are probably seeing over the dash cam here, I'm going by Sheep Mountain. Just absolutely beautiful day out today. I mean, wind's not blowing, temperature's really nice. We had a bunch of snow here, but most of it's melted off already, so winter's not coming on with quite that much of a vengeance yet. But man, had a pretty good little trip home here. Went up, got a few things on the truck fixed. So hey guys, as you can see, Blue's here in the shop. Had to put a new compressor on her, do a few other things. Notice also got the bed hanging out halfway out the sleeper door there. The reason is my heater never has worked since I bought the truck in the bunk. The air conditioning works, but the heat doesn't. So had to get the thing all tore up and get that new little control valve that goes on the bottom there, the little actuator. I'll actually see if I can find that here. I think it's sitting in here somewhere. Yeah, this little puppy right here, little actuator that goes underneath the bunk. What's funny about this is, I'm going to switch cameras here in a second and show this to you. What's funny about this little actuator is these are the same that work the little door on the Chevy trucks, on your dash, the defrosters there. It's the same part, identical. I thought that was kind of funny to find out. So, it's absolutely identical. There's no difference in between them.
Got a little air leak that's been bothering me fixed. Got a new compressor put in the truck, so the compressor's not going to be working as hard now. And it was starting to leak some oil through it, so that was causing some other issues. But we got a few things taken care of there. And now I'm sitting here fat, dumb, and happy without anything wrong on the truck, so that makes me really happy. Being good to go down the road. Just minor things. It was actually the blowgun that was attached to my seat that was leaking, so I put tape on it and everything else and messed with it a couple of times. I finally made it down, bought one at the hardware store instead of the one at the truck stop, because I had a truck stop one I'd installed brand new in here, and it was bad right out of the box. It wouldn't seal up, so the threading on it was just terrible. So I just bought a better made in China product. Yeah, so anyways, I wish I could have found an American made one, but unfortunately that's a tall order these days. But got those few things taken care of. We got her all fixed up and back on the road now. I'm headed down to Billings today. We're going to grab a Trackhoe. It's going to be going down to Denver, Colorado. So let's go get this thing put on the trailer. It is now day two of this load. I'm just climbing out of Billings. Got loaded last night, no problem. Didn't really do any filming last night. I got in, ran into a buddy of mine here at the truck stop. We run for the same company here. He's one of the company drivers over here. I'm an owner operator, obviously. Real good guy. Actually, when I first came on here, wound up running with him a whole bunch, and we ran all over the country together for like a month. It was kind of funny because they kept finding loads and we're running together, so we just kept on running and running and running. So it was a lot of fun doing that. We're out here again. He's got this super big load on here, and you guys watching the time lapse will already be seeing this. He's in this purple and white Peterbilt here in front of me. And if you ask the guy that I'm leased to, he'll tell you this truck's blue. It's purple. But yeah.
So we got.
There's a bull on the shoulder here. I'll just pull over in front of it.
Everything all right there?
She said something was blown up and I'm gonna check it out.
Well, something's flapping, so I'm gonna get out and take a little video for you guys with the cell phone, and we'll see what's going on here. So I just got the crap scared out of me. I hit a bump going over one of these bridges here. They got a little bump at the end of them. Go up, come back down, all of a sudden, crash! I'm like, oh God, what was that? It sounded bad. I turn around, look at the sleeper, and a box of plastic spoons had bounced out of the cupboard and just shattered all over the floor and just made an awful racket. But man, it sounded like something had come up and hit the truck or something. It got me pretty good, so I just had to stop and clean that up here. So. All right, so we got that taken care of. We're back on the road, burning on down. I really ought to put Denver in my GPS, but I know where I'm going. It's Richie Brothers down there, so. And I'll be posting this to the Richie Brothers Twitter, too, so everybody can say hi, and if you buy this machine, you'll know you got it from me, or I'm the one that brought it down to you. Now, you didn't get it from me. I don't own the machine, but I brought it to you. How far is Sam ahead of me now? That's the question. Because he got a little bit of a head start because I took that little video of him taking off there. So I'm playing catch up now. I think he got mad because I was teasing him. Told him he had a purple truck. He says it's blue. Leaving the Wyoming port of entry, Sam has to go over the river and through the woods, and they're sending him down like all the way over to 59, which is way out of route for me, so we're gonna be splitting off from each other here and going our separate ways.
Turn left on road.
But I don't know if I'll see him again tonight, because I might stop at Cheyenne. I don't know if I'll go all the way down to Denver, because parking in Denver is usually pretty limited. I'm 399 miles away right now. Not exactly a hard trip considering it's, you know, Saturday about. Oh, it's not even noon yet. It's 11:39.
Turn right on I-90.
And I'm getting out of here now. So, I mean, really, I've got a day and a half before I'm even, like, getting close. And I can drive this at night. So,
there's no way I can't be on time with this load. Hopefully, I mean, unless like a freak snowstorm shows up and shuts me down, but I don't think that's going to happen. So, get a turn and burn, get on down, and I'll catch up with you guys a little further down the road. Morning. It's Monday morning. I'm just pulling into Richie Brothers. Wound up feeling pretty crappy over the weekend. I got a real bad pressure headache and my vision kind of started getting blurry Saturday, so I wound up shutting down there in Casper and just stayed there. Was really not feeling so great. Got to feeling better yesterday, but I still wasn't 100%, so I just stayed there, rested up, left early this morning. I got out of there about 6, so anyways, I'm here at Richie Brothers now. We're going to hop off here and get this thing delivered and see where they want her. Isn't that right? Should go drop off the machine, huh? Okay. There she is. We got her unloaded. We're here at Richie Brothers. So let's get on out of here. Go get the next one. Alrighty, we are out of here. I just got the paperwork signed. Real nice lady there in the front office. If anyone's actually interested in bidding on this machine I just hauled, this will be going up for auction. It'll be the 16th of December 2014. So if you're watching this before then and you want to bid on that machine, Richie Brothers Auctions, Denver, Colorado. I guess this is Longmont. You could go on there and you can find this machine on that auction there. They'll be selling this on the 16th. So it's a little Cat 320. Seemed to run pretty good. Controls on it work just fine. I didn't see any problems with it. It looked like a solid machine. So there you go. Well, now it is time. I'm going to run down here, go to the Streaking Beacon, and get this truck washed, because this thing is filthy. And I mean filthy. Dirty. Dirty, dirty. After running up there in the sand and dirt and everything else, and running these machines on and off of the trailer, it needs to be washed really bad. So we're gonna get the truck washed, get the trailer douched out. And so the dog could get a 1 liter Pepsi bottle in his mouth without even trying hard. Arr, look at his teeth. Ah, yeah. Arr, ah, yeah. In this case, I'm sitting in Denver traffic right now, trying to go 6 miles, and I am now doing 15 miles an hour. So, trying to get over here, get loaded before this place closes. It's 4:30 right now. They close at 5. I don't know if I'm going to make it or not, because traffic is just insane right now. So, hopefully I can, and we can get this thing going. Otherwise, it'll be first thing in the morning. I'm going to be running down to Albuquerque and picking up down there, or excuse me, delivering down there. Don't know what I'm doing from there. I'm picking up a Trackhoe. I don't know how wide it is yet. You know, you can't run more than 10 foot wide in Colorado at night, so not sure if I'm gonna be able to even do anything with this thing tonight. I might just get it set on the trailer, go back to the truck stop. So we'll have to see. Actually, I may not even be able to leave the property with it. So we'll kind of have to play it by ear here. Man, this traffic is nuts. I'm on 70 right now. Outbound on 70 this time of day is just insane. I'm about a mile and a half right now from the 270 here. Is where I'm going to be turning, going down there to Aurora to load. And, doing about 25 miles an hour now. We might make it, but now we're coming to a stop again. So we'll see what happens here. You guys will see in the time lapse. Actually, you're probably already seeing what's going on because this time lapse is probably going to be as long as my little speech here. But yeah, we'll go get this thing loaded, hopefully, and get on the road. Or if not, we'll see what's happening here. I just got the truck washed and got a few more cleaning things to do on it. Need to finish vacuuming out in here. I had a whole bunch of dog hair in here because while it was real cold, I didn't want to vacuum just because I didn't want to pop all the doors and everything open. So it got pretty bad. Well, we are loaded, and I'm just getting turned around here. It is now 5:50. I can't drive legally for another 10 minutes, so I'm just going to hang out, do my thing, get turned around, be sitting here ready to go as soon as the GPS ticks over, get it programmed, and then I could turn and burn on out of here. So that's what I'm going to do. I still got 2 hours I could drive yet tonight, so I'm going to drive as far as I can. Excuse me, I mean, I'm kind of up against a wall on my 14. Because I started at 6 a.m., which means I can only drive until 8 p.m. So, gonna make it as far as humanly possible. Get out of here, turn around, get up real early tomorrow as soon as legally possible. And get down, I'm gonna try and get to the New Mexico border. And then once I get to the border, I'll be able to hang out there until sunrise, scurry on up to the scale, and once I get up the scale, get my permits for New Mexico, and burn on down the line. So that's what I'm planning on doing. So we'll catch up with you guys later. Well, good morning. I'm just getting up and getting going here. Made it to Pueblo last night just like I wanted to. Now,
when possible,
got up just
make
a little bit
U-turn,
late.
I'm
probably
turn
about
right.
25 minutes or so behind where I wanted to be. Not too bad. I slept in a little bit this morning. So, sun's coming up. Just gotta get down to Albuquerque. Just another 337 miles, so I can do that no problem. It's only 6:45 in the morning right now, so that won't be an issue. Oh, this place is always packed right here.
When
they need more truck stops down
U-turn.
Here. Absolutely need more truck stops because you can barely ever get out of here. Yeah, trucks are parked all over in here and packed in like sardines, which you guys can see from the start of this time lapse. I'm not exactly sure how I'll cut this up yet, but you'll be able to see what's going on down here. But yeah, I think I can swing this corner here. Head back on out. There's all these trucks packed in here, like three deep. All the parking inside taken up. I mean, that's... makes things a little interesting at times. Yeah, I love is you have these creek carrier trucks like the one that I just saw here, which it's probably already gone by in the time lapse, but yeah, I'll just throw a frame of it up there where they have that big thing that points up at the front that says our most valuable resource sits here. Like I would be embarrassed to drive that truck. I mean, if a company has to like I guess what's the word I'm looking for here? I'm kind of tired. If they have to really say it, you know, I would feel like they don't mean it. You know, if they have to put it as a billboard down the side of the truck, it tells me they're having recruiting problems. And that's, you know, I would never look at going to a company that was set up like that, that did that. It'd be just embarrassing to sit in front of that, in my opinion. Of course, you know, I mean, I won't drive a company truck, and I'm kind of hard set about that, but I think it's kind of funny seeing that. If I was sitting in front of that sign, I would be totally embarrassed. I think it's a marketing fail. I would feel totally silly pulling that trailer, and I wouldn't want to do it. So, but yeah, the other thing is,
I-25 south.
I was going to hook up an external camera this morning, but the problem therein is it is so cold, the suction cups won't stick to the outside of anything right now. So I'm not going to risk losing a $400 GoPro camera and, you know, another $40 worth of mount, $60 worth of memory card. So, because if that thing falls off, that's 500 bucks down the drain. And also, they don't make the Hero 3s anymore. You know, you get by the Hero 4, that's a $500 camera. So, you know, then by the time I get the mount and a memory card and everything else for it, you know, that's going to be $600. So that would be an awful big whoopsies to have that fall off the side of the trailer. Like, I follow Allie Knight, and I know she's got a couple of magnet mounts. I think I'm going to look into getting a couple of those. The only thing is, I mean, I'm really cautious about putting stuff like that on the outside of the truck. Because, you know, again, I don't want to lose the camera. The other thing with magnets is, and I know this from the towing industry, is when you stick a magnet to the outside of something, you run the risk of damaging the paint. That's why I like using suction cups. So probably this winter, you guys aren't going to see a whole lot of external camera shots.
Continue on I-25.
That's what it is. I didn't realize there was a Best Buy right up there on the hill. That's kind of good to know. I should like stick that in my file, because sometimes I need to go and get something for the GoPro, and they got that there. But yeah, 336 miles from where I'm delivering to Albuquerque. Just put the hammer down, get her done here. We'll go over the top of Raton. You guys will get to see that. I don't know if I've done a video going over Raton yet. It's an interesting old drive. I mean, it's a pretty hard pull. We'll see how she does with it today. I don't know. Actually, you know, I haven't gone over Raton in this truck yet, this heavy, so it's going to be a good test of the truck today. We'll see how she does.